There are shows that kids love, but their parents get really annoyed by. Keep watching until the end, when we'll show you one show that a celebrity called unbearable. If this is your first time visiting us, then make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to The Things. Today, we are going to show you 10 kids TV shows parents find annoying. Barney and Friends. If you think of a massive purple dinosaur, then the chances are you think about Barney from Barney and Friends. This creature has been keeping very young children entertained since 1992. We think that it's highly likely that Barney helped teach you things when you were very little. However, with Barney being so successful, it's not difficult to see why for some parents he could get annoying. For instance, some parents find his voice gets on their nerves. We'll admit that being subjected to it for any length of time longer than one episode does start to get annoying. And because little kids love Barney and Friends, chances are that their parents just might have to endure quite a lot of him and his prehistoric pals. Also, some parents have spoken about the way the character of Barney talks to kids on the show. They said that they think that Barney can sound pretty patronizing and condescending. They also thought that the children of Barney and Friends were clearly trained actors and not real kids. Those were their words, not ours. So those are some of the reasons why they found it annoying. On the other hand, they realized that Barney's message was positive and harmless. If you are willing to stomach Barney's sweetness, that's a good thing. Teletubbies. When Teletubbies broke onto British TV in 1997, it started a revolution in children's entertainment on television. With Tinky Winky, Dipsy, Lala, and Po, neither kids nor parents had seen anything quite like it. It became an absolute global smash hit, as well as spawning a chart-topping theme song single. If you know it, you're probably singing it to yourself right now. But behind the weird and wonderful colorful creations existed a dark Teletubbies secret. Well, we say secret, but it was actually just a fact, hidden in plain sight. Teletubbies was incredibly repetitive. In fairness, the show was designed to be that way. The idea was that it would teach very young children things by repeating them. Even so, though, it was this sort of thing that ended up annoying parents. What also grinded mom and dad's gears was their diet. As we're sure you know, kids should be encouraged to have a varied and balanced diet. However, it seemed to people that the Teletubbies ate nothing but custard all the time. Not only was this pretty annoying, but it also seemed to give out a pretty bad message. However, we will admit that we thought that the Teletubbies were fun, so it's all a matter of opinion. Hannah Montana. The idea of a young and non-threatening teen idol that kids can look up to is pretty standard in kids' TV, and one of the best examples of that in recent years is the title character from the show, Hannah Montana. The show's concept is that Miley Stewart is a normal teenage girl during the day, but at night, she is an international pop superstar, Hannah Montana. To give the show some credit, it's a cool twist on an old plot, and Miley's character is pretty much based on her actress, Miley Cyrus's life. Both of them have a country singer dad. Miley Cyrus's father is Billy Ray Cyrus of Achy Breaky Heart fame, and they are both pop stars. But like so many other things that are popular, it has its fair share of detractors. Parents who don't like it point out to how polished and shiny everyone on the show is, and there are people who are hating on Miley's voice as well. In fairness, we don't think that it's just parents who get annoyed by Hannah Montana. If you look at how Miley Cyrus herself broke out of her role in the show and got a more grown-up image and sound, we think the star might have ended up being fed up with it too. Peppa Pig. Peppa Pig is a genuinely massive TV phenomenon. The show was watched by a worldwide audience, and it spawned a whole new range of spin-off toys and cinematic experiences. And its cast reads like a who's who of great British comic actors. However, just because kids love it, that doesn't mean that their parents have to too. And quite a few of them don't. They argue that it actually teaches their children bad behavior. Let's look at one example, which is the way Peppa talks to Daddy Pig. Peppa's father is a bit on the tubby side, which is to be expected because he's a pig. However, Peppa seems to take delight in telling him that he's got a big belly all the time. And we can see why parents don't want their kids to think fat shaming is okay. There's also Peppa's love of jumping in muddy puddles. Again, this isn't the sort of habit parents want their children to get into, even though Peppa is always keen to remind them of the importance of wearing boots. If we add to those things just how popular the show is and how much kids will want to watch it, we can see how Peppa Pig could get annoying. Max and Ruby. People have loved cartoon animals ever since Mickey Mouse wowed cinematic audiences all the way back in 1928. However, if you ask some parents, then they'll tell you that there are one pair of animated creatures who are the exception to that rule, and those would be the cartoon stars of Max and Ruby. They are two young rabbit children, and their program explores their adventures and their relationship. But some parents have said that they find the show very repetitive. It's been argued that the show only really has one plot. That would be that Max is trying to say something to his older sister, who ends up ignoring him. Then Max makes a mistake, which annoys Ruby, but it ends up making whatever it is Ruby's doing better. The character of Ruby has come in for a lot of criticism. Some people say that she is incredibly bossy towards Max, and they also query where her parents are through the entire show. But that doesn't mean that Max is completely blame-free either. People have picked up on a way that he only gives one-word answers as another thing that gets on their nerves. Even if you like it, you have to admit that Max and Ruby has generated a lot of hate. Power Rangers. Back in the 1990s, any young kid with any self-respect wanted to be a Power Ranger. At least that's what it felt like at the time. The adventures of these heroes seem to have struck a chord with successive generations, and are as big now as they have ever been. But just because they are popular, it doesn't mean that people like them. In fact, some parents find them to be a bit annoying. And this is a show that has generated a lot of criticism. First of all, people think that the monsters look particularly fake. Some people have even pointed out that the plastic in their masks is obvious, and their mouths don't move when they speak. The jokes in the scripts have also come under fire, with people saying that they just aren't funny. And another thing that parents dislike about Power Rangers is the standard of acting. Some of them say that the performances are clearly scripted and a bit wooden, which takes away from the show itself. But perhaps the most cutting criticism is that the Rangers' weapons don't look all that high-tech. In fact, some parents say that they look like the sort of thing you'd get in a toy store. Sounds like the Power Rangers are under attack. Weebaloo. In the land of Nara, there are four piplins. If you know what that sentence means, then we can tell you that you've seen Weebaloo. If you haven't, it's a children's TV show about four mysterious characters who perform an exercise called yoga, and you can see into the world of human children. They are called Dili, Noctok, Lao Lao, and Yododo. Seems harmless enough, right? Well, some parents have spoken about it and said just how annoyed Weebaloo makes them feel. They say that the show is repetitive and pretty much nonsensical. The thing that seems to get a lot of parents' goats is how the characters talk. They say that the piplins should speak in proper sentences. Another criticism is that the piplins call human children chibis, which is a made-up word. At least one parent has said that she's had to tell her kids not to use that word. The fact that the characters dress in typical gender roles with pink for girls and blue for boys is also under fire. For other parents, the annoyance is more every day. They just don't like the style of animation or the program's theme music. So, Weebaloo isn't quite the show it would like to be. Dora the Explorer. Some kids' TV shows have become so big that they have wormed their way into the heart of popular culture. If you grew up anywhere near the 2000s, then the chances are you'll remember Dora the Explorer really fondly. We certainly do. Who can forget the smart little girl, her monkey boots, and the amazing talking backpack? And what about Swiper? Will he ever stop swiping? But despite our love for Dora the Explorer, some parents think rather differently. For instance, there's the belief that despite the way in which Dora introduces Spanish words and phrases into the show, it does little to promote actual language learning. And there's the character of Swiper, the villainous fox. To be fair, while we loved the Swiper, stop swiping catchphrase, we can imagine how repetitive it might get if your kid binge watches the show. But the character of Dora didn't get a free pass either. Parents noted her tendency to stop and ask where something was when it was just feet away from her face. However, this could easily be a generational thing because these are things that we remember fondly. On the other hand, we can see why it might just get annoying. Paw Patrol. If you're a parent, then we think that there's a good chance that your kid loves Paw Patrol. It's the show about a gang of intrepid young dogs who save the town of Adventure Bay from a range of mishaps. There are a whole bunch of things that have got parents worked up. First of all, there's a sheer range of toys and merchandise available to do with the show. It seems like there's something new Paw Patrol related coming out every day. If you don't believe us, then take a look at the Amazon website, and you'll see that there are more than 6,000 Paw Patrol toys and games. Another thing that has got some parents in a mood about the show is the lack of female members of the patrol. There's Sky, and in the second season of the show, there's Everest. But when you think that there are way more male pop, then we think that might be a bit of a problem. And when you see that Sky has a pretty raw deal all the way through the show, you can kind of agree with parents who don't like it. Plus, it's the sort of show young children will want to watch again and again. Caillou. There are some kids' shows that are just as much for parents as they are for children. There are also some children's television programs that parents can't help but love. But there are also some kids' TV shows that parents really despise. And perhaps the most divisive kids' show around is Caillou. It's a Canadian program about a little boy with a big imagination. But while young children like it, a lot of their parents don't. And a lot of parents have given a lot of different reasons why they dislike the show so much. For some, it's the main character's voice. They say that it's whiny, annoying, and sounds like nails on glass. But that isn't all. The show's catchy theme song has also been blasted by parents, and we can kinda get where they're coming from. One father who said Caillou was French for shut up. It isn't. It's French for pebble, even devoted a rather long blog post to how much he detested the show and the character. The show even has a celebrity hater, former NFL player Arian Foster, who said the show was unbearable. So poor Caillou isn't a popular kid. But we wondered, what kid shows do you find annoying? Don't be shy. Tell us in the comments. And that's all for our 10 kids TV shows parents find annoying. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to The Things.